someday will change the country and the country mentality that Brazil is not only football.
It's a funny country with funny people, and skateboard has everything to do with the Brazilian lifestyle.
My name is Hernani Carveiro. I'm 55 years old and I practice freestyle skateboard. Other fashion. No free advertisement. Okay, that's better. I started in 1977. So I could say it's been 38. I'm not good with calculations. But something like at least 37 years riding skateboard, always freestyle. I even tried skate park and street skating, but my passion is freestyle skateboard because I can do one trick after another one, non-stop. And also I can do it in everywhere, not only on the skate park, but out of them also. We are protesting against all the money spent on the World Cup. You know, this World Cup's been the most expensive cup ever. Why? Because there are many corrupt politicians that they are robbing lots of money from our taxes. And we've got no schools, we've got no hospitals, and we've got no securities. The only security they have is to repress the protest. When it comes to protest, you see lots and lots of police. You know, none of this would be happening if it was for investment on education. I think the first thing in Brazil is education, not football. And freestyle skateboard is very convenient for the protest. Why? Because we don't need a half pipe, we don't need a ramp, or we don't need anything except a flat ground. And in the flat ground, you can go wherever the protesters are. Also, I use this to attract more and more people to the protest. Also, it's very good to calm down when police is about to beat the protest up. So I go ahead, I stay between the crowd and the policemen, and I do my freestyle tricks. So they are kind of mesmerized, and they applaud me, and they kind of laugh. So everybody comes now. 2 years ago, I decided to start a brand just to see how it would be. And it's been kind of successful, maybe because I already have a name on the skateboard. Many skateboarders, they are naturally wearing the t-shirt. So wherever I go, sometimes I see skateboarders wearing t-shirts like this or you know, t-shirts like that. I met one guy at the skate park, and he lives in the favela. And he told me about the kids who could not afford a skateboard and how hard their life is. And I was curious to know more about that. Then I asked the guy if I could visit the favela. And, you know, many people are scared going there. I invite my friends to go with me, but none of them would want to come to the favela. They were very scary because about the drug dealers and all the machine guns. So they didn't want to get shot or killed. But I was not afraid. I was curious. So I went by myself. And I was surprised to see how was the lifestyle in the favela. And then I asked them, what could I do to help them? And then they asked me if I could provide them some good material, some good stuff for them to start skateboarding. And then I went in there. I brought some wheels and some stuff. Also, they liked the t-shirt. When I went there, they saw my t-shirt, so I could see that they liked it. So when I went back there, I brought them also t-shirts.
Well, today we're here at the Mane Skate School, which is a project run by friends of mine who I've known for the last 3 months or so, and I've been coming here because I'm trying to learn how to do heel flips. I'm now 41, I skateboarded between the ages of 12 and 17, and I bitterly regret all those wasted years of not skateboarding, so I'm trying to catch up. I reckon I've got about 5 years of skateboarding left in my knees. I was the first skateboard project I've seen in a favela. You know, you have lots of football projects or music projects or art projects. I've never seen a skateboard one. I think it's a great idea because it sort of goes beyond the stereotype of what a poor person or what a person from a favela should just do, which is maybe play football or do a martial art. Skateboarding's around the world, probably it's a middle class activity. It's not usually associated with poor areas. So I think what they're doing is quite pioneering in a way.
Já tô nascido em 2008. Tinha como objetivo trazer a linguagem do skate para dentro da comunidade, que não era conhecido. Tudo grandioso demais, tem sido de muito proveito. Vários skatistas hoje estão andando bem melhor devido à escolinha de skate. E foi muito bom. A escolinha de skate Maré foi um pontapé inicial para o skate dentro da comunidade. Apoio ainda nenhum, agora com a pacificação é que está vindo, o olhar do mundo está se virando para dentro da comunidade.
Apoio, que quis dizer, patrocínio de
patrocínio
skatista.
De skatista ainda não, e nem tanto de um quanto do outro, nem de governo, mas já tivemos êxito em atletas competindo fora e tirando boa colocação. Dentro da comunidade, o skatista não é muito de protestar. Ele aproveita o momento e vai em frente. Fora, o skatista é muito mais protesto, mas sendo que a comunidade ainda é meio retraída, não é muito de botar a voz, porque tem muita coisa por trás disso. A minha convicção de hoje é que a Copa foi uma jogada política, não foi visando o Brasil, não foi investido no Brasil, não foi investido no esporte, principalmente. E eu acho que a influência da Copa nesse ponto, nesse aspecto, não foi legal.
Proibido de caminhar, é a polícia que está aqui fazendo cerco. Nos proibido de caminhar, é a polícia que mata os meus filhos.
There were already 300 people with the flags and with the costumes. And then more and more protesters start to come. And then when I looked around, there were something like 3,000 protesters. So they blocked the streets. No car could pass anymore with the banners. And then all of a sudden, the police start to attack us for no reason. Oh, and some people called me, telling me they saw my pictures on the paper. So I'm going to check it on Facebook. 81, 82, 83 people like my picture. Yeah, I remember that moment when I was right in front of the banner, all people protesting the back, and in front of me, hundreds and hundreds of policemen. Again, I was between the police and the protesters. Yeah, and I did that before. Last year, I remember when the police was on the verge of attacking us, so I stayed in between them. And I started to do my freestyle skateboard. And then they kind of calmed down, and things this year worked again.
Yes, yes, that's me, my man, Tai Tai from Rio, playing some skateboard around. A lot of sport came from this shit. Snowboarding, the X Games, and a lot of stuff. And why not say it's democratic? If you got a board with four wheels, you can skateboard for free any place, yeah? That's my man doing some tricks there, Mr. Tai Tai from Rio de Janeiro. The owner of Sugar Free, his company, Sugar Free, yes, very nice. He's a very talented man. He's a graphic designer, he's a cartoonist, and he's fun. He's a funny man and good man, yeah.
We know each other since we were 15 years old,
yeah.
Right?
Look at me. It's the 50s, you know? He was born in the 50s. Yeah,
look what plastic surgery did. You know, all the scares, but it was worthwhile.
Yeah.
This is the parliament. So the parliament has a very important role on the political situation of Rio. Last year, after the protest, we came up here to rest. Then lots of skateboarders sat down there, and some were talking about what happened in the protest. And then the police came. All of a sudden, lots of policemen. They start to shoot us, a tear gas here. So we had to run over there. So this is all begun. So a new riot began, but this time only with the skaters. I think there is something like 200 skateboard, and we made a barricade over there. This is the other half of my life. I work at Tribunal de Justiça. It means Court of Justice, and I work as an analista judiciário, that means law analyst. One thing I like about my job is that I'm working now with criminal cases, and it's very exciting to attend the court with the biggest criminals in Rio. And one thing I don't like about working here is because I have no creativity. You know, I have to obey the laws. They are very restrictive about the laws. I have to do exactly what they want. I can't be myself. I have to use a social mask. And when I step out of the court, I'm myself, I'm Tai Tai, the skateboarder, the protester, the guy who doesn't accept the way society's being ruled. You know, I don't agree with many laws. The laws can be legal, but sometimes they are immoral.